area here.
You will be down this side?
We just have to stand.
You'll be on the other side?
Yes, we'll wait.
You'll have a little stand up there for a while, it's here, before you sit down.
Wait in here.
I'll let Eddie.
Eddie, you might as well bring a tray in right away, they're ready.
Yeah, we're on that side, but we're, I think they're bringing in some trays and cocktails.
Doug, what's going on there?
How is Mrs. Brady?
Just fine, she happens to be out of the city.
She's in New York.
Right now.
I think I was watching out.
Mrs. Reagan and Attorney Andy, third best commissioner.
Yeah, well, please return the answers.
And that is this woman, right now.
She is now thinking a great deal about what program for her.
This is white wine, do you like it? Sherry, apple juice, cranberry juice, orange juice, and a whole other tray of the same.
Yes, nice to meet you, it's a Californian.
I know that you like the Californian wine.
Yes. And I'm going to find out about some others, thank you.
That's why you should put the TV on.
I'm going to stay with the apple juice too. You can hear I'm a little husky there. I've been home told that I'm an alcoholic, while that's there, I'm only aggravated.
Вчера у нас был прекрасный вечер.
Yesterday we had a very good
party.
With the Secretary of State, he made sure that.
Смотрели старые музыкальные фильмы.
We had see a movie which is about old musicals.
Сочетание с американской кухней.
That's entertainment, and they showed one big scene. I kept expecting your face to show. It was an MGM big party some years ago.
Yeah, well, I was at Warner Brothers.
Oh, you were at Warner Brothers, so that's why. Wrong studio.
And I wasn't in musicals.
Hey, man.
No, but they showed. They had Clark Gable there for instance. But the, from my standpoint, because his wife and my wife have become very friendly. And she was going to come and have tea with my grandchildren, but she had to cancel that film. So we sent her some pictures.
You could have shown one of my movies.
But when you have singing and dancing,
yes,
then you don't have much need for translation because everybody is going to be a language.
That's right.
С вашим участием фильмы очень популярны.
The films with you are quite popular. Very popular. Yes.
По-моему, я не первый.
Probably not the first person to say that.
Indicate to those that which is really strong force.
Я знаю, что очень успешно идет предвыборная кампания.
I know that the vice president is having a very successful campaign.
Very arduous campaign. Thank you.
Going reasonably well, right?
That's the understatement of the year.
Hey, maybe. This is... I don't think you've been in this room before.
Yes, it's the first time I'm here. Maybe this is the only White House room where I can't be.
Well, this is a story room. This is called the Roosevelt Room. And that is the Nobel Peace Prize he won for bringing about the settlement of the Russo-Japanese War. That's Theodore Roosevelt, not Theodore. That's him right behind you on the horse.
Mm-hmm.
I've always thought he's kind of abusing that horse.
Yes, probably he is. Yes.
This room is likely to stay named the Roosevelt Room because there was a Roosevelt who was a Democrat, Franklin Roosevelt, and a Roosevelt who was a Republican, Theodore Roosevelt. So neither party has an incentive to change the name of the room when they
the president. Другой республиканец. Это
нойзи.
С большой вероятностью никто не будет менять название какого.
Theodore Roosevelt, is it his time that this whole wing of the building was decided to build previously?
При его администрации как раз было принято решение, чтобы достроить это крыло Белого дома.
The White House was not only the residence of the presidential family in those days, but it was also where the executive offices were.
Белый дом в то время, значит, использовали не только для места, где жил президент и его семья, но также были разные члены кабинета, которые работали, то есть у них были свои кабинеты.
And it could get pretty confusing.
И было не трудно разобрать, кто чем занимается.
And one day, Mrs. Roosevelt said to him, if I'm going to raise 6 children in this house, you're going to get your people out of here.
Супруга, миссис, ему заявила, говорит, если ты ожидаешь, что я буду воспитывать в этом доме 6 детей, то всех твоих работников и других членов твоей администрации надо убрать.
And that's how this, what's called the West Wing, came into being.
Называется Западное крыло. Being so late and welcoming you.
Just no need to apologize. I'm very happy that I'm able to meet you again.
Well,
especially on this day, after the work of yesterday.
Well,
nice to see you.
Glad to see you again.
Fine.
Very fine.
You remember
again,
many meetings before.
Very well. You know Howard Baker, sir?
Howard Baker, how are you, sir?
I think we meet first.
Happy to know you.
Pleasure. We've been through. Mr. President, I remember my right to say goodbye to you.
Like that.
Yeah, Mr. Bush is remembering that we were back last year. He's our good.
I'm trying to think when that was. 3 years, somewhere in there.
We had a meeting in Berlin.
That was earlier, yeah.
Again in 83, and then down in your office.
Well, we're looking at your leadership to go to consensus, Federal Republic of Germany, a consensus on NATO policies. I think that's very important if we deal with Soviets and something we've just been talking about. I think are the result of that unity that has been achieved, and the with them, we always stress the matter of arms control, but I think that East-West relations, even more than arms control, the closed borders, including the Berlin Wall and all, these are real obstacles that I think we should continue working on. And we hope that the SPD will speak out for human rights.
And congratulations on the Socratic Award from the AHEPA.
Thank you so much.
Ambassador George Papoulias.
Mr. President, we have great honor to say that today you are signing the bill and you are receiving us here, sir. I'm absolutely so sensitive to this.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Andrew Athens.
Mr. President, how are you? We're finding out my baseball comes in.
Hey,
how about that?
Well,
18
years.
Mr. Nicholas Stride.
Salt Lake City, Utah, 1968, the first committee for Reagan for president.
Yes,
thank you.
Mr. President, Peter Carter.
I'm Peter Greedy from New York. Well, I had to see you.
Mr. President,
Tom Corlett.
Hang in there.
That was a surprise.
And Father Alex Cohen.
Thank you, right. Mr. President. Well, assistant to the Archbishop. It's a pleasure. Thank you, sir.
I'm pleased. I think we have to get some photographers in the
You want to help us get everybody situated for the skills in?
Probably is, because if we trace, okay, we trace all that we love here in our own civilization and country back to Greece.
Mr. President, excuse me, we'll bring the still photographers in.
Right.
Yes.
Southern part of Ireland.
Reganopoulos.
Reganopoulos.
Reganopoulos. All right. It is done.
Thank you very much.
Well done. Well, thank you, President. Right. Well, I know we're going to continue trying to increase our relations with Greece.
Can I address these words to you? Mr. President, the Greek Orthodox Americans representing the fourth major faith, coming in gratitude and deep respect to celebrate and to dedicate ourselves to the ideals and values of the democracy of the Soman Church, in this land in which has its origins in the ancient Greek democracy of Periclean times. History will record your leadership as one of the most illumined and the most daring ones, for you have led our nation to the highest degree of self-esteem and as well as by other nations. Your bold initiatives and actions in regard with the intermediate range nuclear forces have earned you universal admiration and respect. To truth, justice, freedom, and democracy, you have given new and real dimensions. We pray that God may sustain you in his loving care for many years to come, and you may seal your presidency with two more accomplishments, namely peace in the Middle East and in Cyprus.
And now, I don't want to come in your help.
I'm willing to offer any help I can. And now permit me to place around the necklace historic cross of St. Andrew, which goes back to the Justinian times, the 6th century.
Well, the guy. Thank you very much.
And present you with this citation, which I may read, in recognition of his fearless advocacy of freedom and democracy for the peoples of the world, and for his intrepid dedication to human rights and social justice for all mankind. Supreme in his commitment to the American spirit, with the grace of God, we do hereby confer upon Ronald Wilson Reagan, our President, the Silver Cross of the Order of St. Andrew.
Well, thank you very much.
And may we hope that you will remember from time to time the profound love and appreciation which will fill all our hearts, of all of us, of the American community for many years to come. I'm very grateful to you and very proud of you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. You honor me greatly.
The Greek nation gratitude, Mr. President. Thank you. Honor us today.
Thank you very much.
Mr. President.
Congratulations. Thank you very much. Well, this is...
May I have another proclamation?
What?
May I have the proclamation?
Your Eminence. And,
we'll have to make a copy. We'll get you that one as soon as copies are...
That has to go through the bureaucracy.
That's great. That's
all right.
Thank you.
So thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I heard you mentioning Irish and so forth back here. I was just told the other day a true story, and I'll just take a second to tell it to you. A little Irish girl came home from school. She'd been naughty, had a note with her. So when the family gathered around the dining table, she was over in the corner at a little table all by herself facing the wall. And then the family heard her saying grace, giving thanks before the dinner. She was saying, "Thank thee, Lord Jesus, for preparing a table before me in the presence of mine enemies."
Thank you. I appreciate it. Okay. Once again, thank you.
Thank you.